Welcome to Red United TV. It's your boy, Ivorian Spice, and welcome to the Catch Up Volume 11, guys. Another week, another show, guys. An eventful week we've had so far within Manchester United from Sunday all the way up to now. I've got my two boys, Amok, and I've got Jake beside me. Amok, what are you saying?
Another week, another time to share our opinions with you.
How are you feeling?
I'm feeling a little bit better now, but let's see.
And Jex, what are you saying, bro?
I'm good, man. A couple wins for United over the past week, so I can't complain.
A couple?
Yeah,
that's true. We did beat Brighton twice. Yeah. All right. As you know, our last game that we played, of course, we won against Brighton. We played Brighton back-to-back from Saturday all the way up to yesterday, which was, what, Wednesday?
Yesterday.
Yeah, Wednesday. We happened to win both of the games. The other game that we played yesterday in the League Cup I wouldn't say it went smoothly. It went well in the second half.
Second half, yeah.
The previous week, we're going to look at the previous match, which was on Saturday. Boy, oh boy, oh boy. Saturday's match against Brighton. 90 minutes. That dilemma, you know? All that dramatic, ending. It was nerve-wracking. Nerve-wracking, guys.
You don't understand. My brother and my friend came in there. They caught me. I was nervous. I literally wanted to cry when they equalized.
But, boy, guys, what we have to say. So, my personal opinion of that match, first of all, against Brighton on Saturday, we was lucky. We was lucky, guys. And you all know that we was lucky against Brighton.
Definitely.
That 90th minute, I've never seen that in my whole entire life. My whole entire life of watching football, I've never seen that type of ending. But that was a blockbuster ending. And thank God we got the 3 points, but the performance was atrocious. You know, a lot of people need to sort themselves out. But Amok, I want to give it to you. What was your personal opinion of that match? You know, what did you think of that match? Who was your man of the match as well? Let me know who your donkey of the match was with that match as well.
I can't really give man of the match. I can only say Bruno because he scored the last goal.
Yeah.
Because he could have been someone else taking and missed that penalty and obviously sooner draw the match. Yeah. But it was just one of the games that you don't need to repeat himself again. It was stressful, long, and like you said, we just got to be happy and appreciate the fact that we won. But we didn't deserve to win. I can say this again and again. We did not deserve
Definitely
to win.
Not. Definitely not.
And my donkey of the match again, for the second time in a row, is going to be Ollie.
Ollie. Last week, donkey Ollie of the match. This week, donkey of the match. Jez, what was you saying about that match when you watched it?
It was a very, very poor performance.
Yeah.
I don't want to be too negative because when it comes to the Premier League, the most important thing is 3 points.
True,
we bagged the 3 points.
True.
Another penalty at the end. A bit of controversy, but we got the 3 points. But to be fair,
you sound like a professional football player right there. So it's all about the 3 points. I'm this guy that has scored 3 goals. It was amazing, but I'm very happy you got the 3 points.
The template answer, isn't it?
Yeah, the 3 points.
But yeah, poor performance. Brighton were all over us. For us to be dominated by Brighton is quite embarrassing.
Yeah.
But yeah, we got the points. Yeah, just move on from there, really. But yeah, poor performance from us. Very poor.
And then yesterday we played Brighton again in the second game against them. What was that? Amex Stadium again?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Away. We won 3-0. Like I said before, I'm not going to say we won 3-0 comfortably because the first half was atrocious.
Mm-hmm.
It was boring.
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't believe what I was seeing. We were just struggling against their second team. Even though we played our second team in the League Cup, yeah, it doesn't really matter. Still, we want to see a good performance regardless. That first half was atrocious. It was boring. I couldn't believe what I was seeing until we got our first goal. Then it started looking a bit interesting. The second half, two of our boys came on, Rashford, Labile, Pogba. Done their thing, you know. I was so happy to see Pogba score. Oh, what did you guys think? Were you happy to see Pogba score?
Of course. Deflection, but still a goal. And he looks happy. So, but, yeah.
Do you know what's so funny about that free kick?
What?
Neil Mope. Why the hell was he? Did you see Mope? Well, I was on his knees. What was he trying to stop?
He's tired.
Why would you go on your knees behind your players? What if it was the bull that was had power and hit the player and you stand behind your player? You're going to cause damage. That player's going to fall over you and you might break your arm or something.
Was he behind the wall?
Was behind the wall.
Kneeling.
There's some tactics to prevent the low. Because you know when the wall jumps?
The low
shot.
Yeah, but it's too dangerous for your other players. not the Manchester players, but the Brighton players, they could just stand behind you. If you're in school, go behind you, and everyone's parents would just push me, and you doing the same thing. What happens to me when that happens? Fall and help myself.
And you know what was so funny? It went through that gap where he was standing. I just love that. It's like, hey, hope it's not your week.
Hey, I was happy when that ball went in. Uh-huh. I was really happy. I don't know if you lot felt the way I felt yesterday.
I was happy.
Pogba have been going through a whole lot of hard time. Remember, we've played 2 games already in the Premier League. Mm-hmm. I've seen social media trending on Pogba. Say Pogba's second game, he's played poor. His performances were poor. Everything about Pogba was poor. I actually said that I want to see more from Pogba.
Yeah, of course.
Everyone's poor, but they forget that the whole team was poor, as always. Always late, need to find escape, always blaming Pogba. My wife broke up with me, Pogba. You know what I mean? I don't understand. Why?
To be fair, we all know Pogba's not a leader, and it's evident when he plays with France.
Mm-hmm.
He needs quality players around him for him to shine. He can't handle the pressure of being a leader. So once we get a couple more, even better players in, you'll see him shine away from the limelight, you know?
Yeah, guys, we'd like to mention a couple of things. The first thing that we need to talk about during that first game that we played against Brighton on Saturday, that handball incident. Because so far during the weekend, the Premier League, handball has been a big topic, big issue. VAR's been picking up handballs all over.
Left, right, centre.
Mm-hmm.
That's due to the new rules. The handball rules has changed from last season to this season now. And James, what's the rules like?
From what I understand, basically, if you're in a box,
yeah,
the ball just has to touch your hand and it's automatically a penalty.
Even if you're just rubbing your eyes?
There you go. Mm. Even if you have your hands in your pocket, right, it's still a penalty.
What if you try to turn away from... You know, sometimes players have a shot, uh-huh, you're trying to turn around... Like, protect yourself, right?
Yeah, yeah.
What if the ball hits your hand?
The same thing happened to Lindelof against Crystal Palace. He was just running and it hit his hand and it became a penalty.
Well, so what happened to that rule called ball to the hand? Did that rule
that disappeared? Yeah. That disappeared. We're now in line with the rest of Europe. I personally feel like it's absolutely killing the game. Because if I was a manager, I'm telling my attacking players, you're skillful enough. When you're in the box, just flick the ball onto their hand and we'll get a penalty. There's too many penalties now because of this handball rule, and I'm pretty sure that the FA are going to have a look off the back of players and managers appealing it, and it will be changed very soon.
But it can't be changed during the middle of the season. I thought the rules would get changed at the end of the season going into a new season.
Possibly, yeah. I do understand what you're saying.
By January, if possible, because it's affecting the football playing itself.
Yes.
How the players play football, like he said. We got to be skillful and just keep killing the ball in the half.
Yeah,
we was very unfortunate about the handball because we conceded the penalty because one of our players what handball.
Lindelof against Crystal Palace. Yeah.
Oh, Lindelof. I don't know him by Lindelof no more. I call him Lindelof. He's expired Indian takeaway. That's what he is. But yeah, well, what else happened on that week? So if we move on, we're gonna talk about what. That stupid partnership between Harry Maguire and Victor Lindelof. Because boy, that game against Brighton on Saturday, they were suspect.
Let me tell you this. Baye is our second centre-back. As I said last week, he just needs to keep fit. For me personally, after one matter, he was man of the match. Against Brighton. Second man of the match, if you can give a second one.
100.
He's quick.
Yep.
He's tenacious. He's aggressive. At times, he can't concentrate for the full 90 minutes. He does a couple of rash things. But if he can keep fit and keep concentrated for the full 90 minutes, it will be, for me personally, Baye and Maguire. They both need to start. Lindelof, for me, he's a fourth centre-back choice at best. So please, Baye, keep fit. So we can enjoy a better defence. Because Lindelof doesn't cut it.
Baye needs to go back to Ivory Coast and go and visit the shrine with the witch doctor to keep him fit. I ain't gonna lie, I'm not trying to promote bad stuff, but my man needs to go back to Ivory Coast, go visit the shrine and visit the witch doctor and tell him, listen, who put voodoo on me that I keep getting injured each time? Even when I go to the toilet, I take a piss, I pull a hamstring. I don't know what's going on. I just don't know what's going on. But I just want to see Baye fit because I believe Baye is our best defender. From the moment he came in, I said, That is our best defender.
Mm-hmm. Well, you can just tell from yesterday's match in the other game. But yesterday, from our show stopper, he actually took on the show. Like, I was impressed with every single thing. Like we said, he can't concentrate for 90 minutes because he ain't played 90 minutes for a very long time. But his interceptions, tackles, I was like, whoa. If I remember, the commentator was saying that he's too harsh, sometimes he gets sent off. But sometimes you need players like that.
Vidic.
He
was aggressive.
And I'll tell you another player that he played for us. He was standing like a striker, but he's ended up playing midfield, like more like a, I think, left side midfield.
Who's that?
This old school Alan Smith. His tackles. That's his tackle. He never missed that before. That's when I see Bailey doing them same tackles. He reminds me of it. Okay. But Bailey's one is too kind of rough. Like you might feel like he's going to get sent off or something. But I love when he does it, when he gets it. And yesterday, spot on. Everything he did yesterday. Bailey, we miss you. We want to see more of that. Mm-hmm. I want to see more of that.
Mm-hmm. Well, and we say to start off for Saturday for Sunday against Spurs?
Of course.
But you should.
He should stop.
Maguire and Bailly for the rest of the season, for me personally.
I mean, I don't want to see no Vindelof no more, man.
I told him last season, a few seasons ago, I don't rate Vindelof.
Nah.
Well, I've been saying like for a very long time.
He's a suspect. But for me, the number one suspect we got, Maguire. Maguire is the big suspect.
Yeah, he's a suspect, but Vindelof, yeah?
Like, what you got to understand, like, okay, maybe the first two games this season, yeah, you could say Vindelof have shown, like, signs that maybe we might need another centre half. You get what I mean? Which we definitely need another centre half. But Maguire, from the end of the last season to this season, starting, he's been shaky. Like, and do you know what I'm saying? Then, do you know what I'm saying, Maguire? We spent 80 million. It took us almost two seasons to sign this player. And we got someone that we wanted so much. What is he doing for us? And he's the captain.
Well, he's doing what we can. But you know one thing I don't like about Vindelof? I keep on saying before. One thing I don't rate is the lack of strength. I'm like, the lack of strength and bravery. I'm there thinking, you can go on holiday and chase an old man robbing an old woman's wallet, but you can't handle a man like Zaha. Like, you're brave enough to chase a robber, but you can't even handle a man like Zaha for strength.
He needs to work on it. That's true.
He gets bullied
a lot.
You know what? That's what happens when you see a man like him be dressing in dresses like. True. Like,
remember, I showed you a picture and we had that little debate and he said, oh, you don't rate him. I said, maybe he's doing it.
I don't rate him no more. Like, this that tells me that his lack of strength. He's dressing in dresses. I'm not offending no one, but I'm just saying that he wasn't in a dress. He can't handle Zaha. He gets moved to by any man. Even a 1-year-old can have him up. I don't understand this Lindelof guy.
I think he needs time off. You remember when we got Mkhitaryan, right? We didn't play him for almost 2 months. Just to build his strength, right? And they gave him a chance after the 2 months, right? When he came back in, he was the best player we had during the Europa competition. I think Lindelof did the same thing. So how are we going to put Lindelof on the bench if we don't replace Lindelof with someone else?
I know. But that will happen. But guys, let's move on to our team's ability to cope. I watched that game. Yesterday's game, Saturday's game.
Even against Luton Town.
Even against Crystal Palace. Even last season at the start. What's your opinion of Manchester United's coaching? Like, the way we play. Like, what you see on the pitch.
At the back end of last season, when we came back from COVID, we saw that we were creating more opportunities, we were scoring more goals, winning games by 2, 3, 4 goals. And it seems to have died down a little bit now. I feel like the coaches aren't good enough, unfortunately. We need better coaches. Unfortunately, I haven't done research into what coaches we could possibly bring in. I'm not too sure.
You'd be good. I'd be good. We know what to say. Yes, I know.
But I think our key problem for United, when teams sit back, we don't have a plan A, B, C, D, or E. It's literally just
A.
Guess.
It's or just guess.
A.
It's or only B. Ball, freestyle football.
Thank you. We need to change it up. We do need better coaches into our team.
Yep,
true.
And Monk, you said this earlier, Ole didn't even bring in anyone.
No. He didn't bring his own boys. He didn't bring his own boys.
How are you going to, as a manager, football manager, right? You go hire a football club. But first thing you do is select your own staff, that coaching staff.
Mm-hmm.
Ole did not do that. Ole got given staff from Manchester United. The team itself put people together for Ole to work with.
And that's how you know he didn't come down on his own
terms. You get what I mean? And when you see that, you know we are in trouble.
You can literally tell that he got bent over by Ed Woodward and said, you're going to take some of this.
I told you, Dominique. Yeah. He's under a choco. Ed got Ole under a choco. And when he said like this, but at the end of the day, mm-hmm. I understand what you're saying. If I was to talk about the coaching and I was to rate our coaching to compare to the top six, but our 100, my coaching should be like 40%. Maybe up to 50%. That means you're not that good.
I just wish
40% out of 100.
I just wish Manchester United addressed that coaching because I want our team, our beloved team, to play like the way Bayern Munich play, the way Liverpool play. That machine type of... You can tell that the team is well-drilled.
They've got the players.
They're just a machine. You look at the team. Whenever they touch the ball, whenever they pass with purpose, with intent. Mm-hmm. Everything that they do makes sense. The players are running and getting to position, moving into spaces. Like, I just want that. I want that. But I just don't understand why don't we have that?
How are you going to get that? How are you going to get that when your manager, your actual manager is sitting... like 10 feet away from the actual pitch.
What do you guys think about this Ole guy sitting there and never going to the touchline?
Do you know what?
Watching from a TV screen.
Thank you.
But can't affect it from that TV screen.
He's about 20 meters, as you just said, 20 meters away from the pitch. It looks like he's playing Football Manager on the side. He's got his screen. I don't know what he's doing. Is he playing Football Manager? Is he on YouTube? Is he FaceTiming his missus? Who knows? It's very, very disheartening to see a poor performance. For instance, just Brighton last night.
Yeah.
First half was very poor.
Very poor.
Ole was sitting down. Other managers, 18 out of 20 other managers in the Premier League will be on that touchline feeding instructions.
Exactly.
We're playing poor. Plan B. Do this, do that. But he just sits there and just relaxes. What?
Sits there, crosses his foot over, and his hands in his pocket.
Yeah.
That's how you know he's just...
I'm upset, Ole.
He's open and praying.
I told you, Pete, do you remember? I said, Ole reminds me of Mourinho. They always got their hands in the pocket. You know a winner.
Mourinho does a bit more.
No, Ole does it more. Recently, Ole be doing it a lot. Every single game we see Ole,
he's got both hands.
And how you gonna be my manager? I need my players to be motivated and not something like this.
Mm-hmm.
Hiding your face. It's like you're soaking over something that we don't know about, or you stress over something. Like he said, he's been stressing. We don't know if he's stressing. Like when we didn't know was it Jesse was stressing over family issues, right? Mm-hmm. Till they came out in the media. So Ollie, if you know you're stressing too, go out in the media and tell the media that I'm stressing. Because what we've seen so far, Ollie, that's not good attribute for a manager. Actually, the manage Manchester United. This is too big, Ole. You gotta respect this. Mm-hmm. You can't be sitting behind there and let the players do whatever they want to do.
Mm-hmm.
We need more from you, Ole. We need to see more from you, Ole.
Definitely.
Yeah, I'm just literally tired of seeing him sit down with his crossing his what's left over his laps and all that stuff. I really would like to see Ole be a coach and actually coach or manage. He's way into a match to win, you know? Because you're a manager, or you're a coach, whatever he is. A public figurehead for the team. I don't know. Like, sometimes I don't know what Ole is anymore. Because is he a manager? Is he a PE teacher? Is he someone that's on an apprenticeship course? You know, is he a coach? What the hell are you, Ole? We need to know what you are. And it's not like, this is, I don't like Ole or Ole hate speech. I just want to know what my manager is. Because right now, I don't know what he is anymore. He's a clueless man to me.
Ole,
he's clueless.
Stop with that screen.
Mm-hmm.
Stop playing Football Manager on the side.
Yeah.
Unless you want them to deduct season ticket from your salary. We're just watching.
We don't want to compare you to other managers, but you could be more exciting if you're on the touchline actually pointing fingers at your player. People will see more character in you than you just sitting there doing this, doing 99 poses for us, like we want to see the poses.
Just be like me. Be like me when I'm at work.
Be agile.
Pretend to work. Just be on that track and pointing, you know. I will believe, you know, when my manager walks in and I'm out here doing idle time, doing nothing, I start typing, I'm typing gibberish, but they think I'm working hard. Do that!
Do you remember Benitez? When they, Scratchables caught him writing notes and all he had was arrows towards the goal saying shoot,
score. But if we never just saw that, if we never saw that from Benitez, we'll think, raw, this guy is strategizing.
Yeah.
And in the day, he's strategizing, he's doing what he needs to do to get there, but you can't do that. Just fake it for me. At least fake it. Just fake it.
We just want to see more LP. And do you know what bothers me as well? Is that, like you said before, I just want to emphasize a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Our football always been trash. Do you know what I'm saying?
Definitely.
Our football always been trash. I told
since LP, when though?
No, since before Mourinho, no, since Mourinho, okay. Football went dead. Because okay. Van Gaal, during Van Gaal's era, I think we played the best football during that Van Gaal. We just didn't score goals. And but we played very good football.
Mm-hmm.
We've been getting 70-80% of the ball percent possession every single game, even when we lose. But we can't just like Oli, football is not really good. And the reason I'm saying this, I'm gonna give you like two examples. Before the lockdown, how did we start? Very poor, right? And the only thing that changes Manchester United was Bruno. And when Bruno came, another lockdown, right?
Yeah.
And we came back. Mm-hmm. Why do you think we're doing good? It's because of Corona. Players are tired, maybe whatever we had going on for us helped. But that was the problem, why that's the problem with other teams losing and we winning. I didn't get gas because we were winning. I knew it was something up. I was waiting for this new season and I proved myself already.
But yeah, as you said before, you said our team is trash. Our football's trash.
Trash, football's trash.
You know, Ollie, don't make women say this is the reason why men are trash. We don't want to be sponsoring men are trash, you know. We don't want to be sponsoring men or trash.
Nah, we don't.
You're making the reason why men are trash because of you, Oli. Our team is trash. Our players are moving like they're trash. No one's got confidence. But we move, guys. We had our Champions League draw today. I don't know if you guys seen a draw today.
I have.
Let's briefly talk about our draw. We have PSG. Yeah. Leipzig that beat Tottenham. Yeah, and then got knocked out. I don't know. Last team, I just don't know who they are. It starts with a B, yeah. Something like that. I don't know
Turkish
if they're a Portuguese team or Turkish.
Turkish.
But at the end of the day, to me, we have a group of death.
Definitely. 100%.
We got PSG.
PSG and what's called?
The team that beat.
Luckily, that Werner's gone and all that stuff, but still, they're a danger. Upamecano. We're going to be playing against Upamecano.
Mm-hmm.
The player that we were trying to sign during the summer. My personal feeling of this group stage, this group that we're in, I don't know if we'll make it through if we don't sign any players. And if we don't improve our coaching, the way we play, then yeah. And one thing I want to mention about Oli is that Oli proved to... which I didn't mention before, guys. Sorry, I just want to go off topic. That's Oli proved to Ed Woodward that he can do the job by finishing third.
Mm-hmm.
Why didn't he have the balls or the cojones to go to Ed Woodward and say, can I bring in some of my coaches, please?
No, because I told you, Ed got him on the chopboard.
We don't want mold.
No, I'm just saying, he had his own team.
We don't want mold coaches.
Every manager comes with their own team.
He's saying one thing. You see, you don't want this.
Yeah.
The whole thing is, Ole is not capable enough. He's not competent enough to be manager at Manchester United. I'm actually starting. We're not upset. We're not upset.
As I was saying earlier on, I just don't believe that we will go through to the next round. We could end up back in Europa League or out. What about you, Jakes?
I want to be quietly confident.
You want to be quietly confident?
I do want to be quietly confident.
Because you think that Jakes will be signing Sancho, whoever, right back, whatever. Is that because of that?
No. Leipzig, they're a good team. Les Werner, a decent team. I feel like we will come second. It's all about how we play on the day. If we're confident, I reckon we can do it. I'm hoping for a Champions League knockout stage for next year, but who knows? It might be UEFA Cup. Who knows?
And Amuk?
For me, it's 50-50.
It's 50-50 for you. 50-50. Why is that?
I just don't have that much belief in my team that I can see us pulling through Champions League.
Mm-hmm.
Nah.
Because
Champions League is different competition.
It's different. Like, it's different. Different sorts of gravy. Like,
trust me, we all seen what happens. And I'll tell you like this, as an example, we beat PSG, right?
Yeah.
Did you think we deserve to be PSG and qualify that day? No.
Yeah,
we did not. what we did. So that's that, I'm not scared about PSG because I know when Manchester are facing the big team,
yeah,
we turn up for some reason. We do. But it's the other teams, the small teams, I'm scared of. Like they will disgrace us, they will disrespect us. So for me it's 50-50.
That's cool. 50-50. I would say no chance. He believes.
Quietly confident. Come on.
He's quietly confident. You know that? He's quietly confident. So he's hiding behind the corner saying.
He's hiding by Oli. Oli, push Oli.
As soon as we go through, I told you we're going to go through.
And Oli did the same thing yesterday. He was hiding. As soon as we got 3 goals up,
he was on the touchline. I don't understand that. Don't do that.
Don't do that.
Don't do that.
We love you, Dolly. We got love for you.
Of course.
We're proud fans.
Of course.
We love you so much. We love this bad bear in you, though. So we want to see more from you.
Trust me. Trust me.
And guys, let's briefly talk about rumors. I mean, transfer rumors right now.
Oh, God.
So far.
Oh, God.
Like, guys, I don't know what you've seen in the news.
Oh, God.
We have been linked to 2 players, Cavani.
Jesus.
And Dembele from Barcelona.
Oh, God.
I know you. I have a feeling that you might like the Dembele. I know you. But me, yeah.
I like stylish players.
My personal opinion, we've been linked to the team. I will take Dembele, but at the end of the day, we're wasting no money. Because in there, we're signing someone that's going to be fighting and scrapping with Phil Jones for the physio bench with Dalot as well. What's the point? Going to come in and say, that's my bench. No, Jones, I've been here for 9 years.
Yeah.
This is my bench. I got married on this bench. I've been here for that long. I got married, conceived my first child on this bench. I thought this physio saw everything, you know? But yeah.
Let's be optimistic, right?
Mm-hmm.
We signed Van Persie. He was injury prone from Arsenal. He came Manchester, done the thing for us.
For the first season.
True. So why can't it? For me, we need quality. Like you said, Dembele got quality.
Dembele's got quality, but his muscles and hamstrings are made out of breaststicks and toothpicks. So I don't know why you want him. Why do you want someone who's got breaststicks and toothpick for legs? His thighs are made out of breaststicks and legs are made out of toothpicks.
On a normal day, when he's fit, you can compare him to anyone.
Yeah, but Moro. Now, because you upset me, I have to call you by your full government name.
It's okay.
Yeah. Since he's been signed, Ousmane Dembele for Barcelona, what has he shown? He's been injured for 3 seasons.
Maybe he needs to needs another challenge. Come to the Premier League.
Where is he? All of a sudden, comes to the Premier League, he bulks up his leg.
B, like I said, our team is shot.
Mm-hmm.
We haven't got enough quality. Like what? Yeah. When the show started, what did you mention?
Keyword sure.
Bobo needs quality running to function, right? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Have we got enough quality?
No,
we don't. But we won't have any of the Dembele's quality because he's going to be injured throughout the whole season. We're going to get him all alone.
See, that's what I said.
And we're still going to be
optimistic. Optimism could help us through whatever we're going through.
Jeff, what are you saying about this transfer beat rumors?
For me, Dembele is. Only because we can't get Sancho. And the club don't want to spend an extra 20 million on
and he doesn't want to come. Let me tell you that now. We're trying to convince him to come.
Well, why are you in the sense that he doesn't want to come?
He doesn't want to leave Barca.
This is what I'm saying, yeah? Eduardo needs to go. How are you going to have a deal with Sancho? And at the end of the transfer period, you want to go get Dembele. He doesn't want to come to your team.
Don't get twisted. If we can't get Sancho for some reason, I'd love it on deadline day for us to actually not purchase Dembele, get him on loan.
But it is a loan that
an option to buy later. So yeah, let's have a look at what he does for
and
one
see
season.
And then,
to be honest,
I take that.
Let's just get Sancho.
I'm not gonna
take Sancho all day, every day. Is my number one favorite.
As soon as you get Ousmane Dembele, just prepare another physio bench for him to sit on for the rest of the season. Him and Jones are going to
probably
hold
hands.
Let's be optimistic. I just like his quality because I've seen. Remember, I don't want to say this. I don't want to take whatever you're doing off topic.
Yeah.
He used to whoop me on FIFA using Borussia Dortmund, right?
Yeah.
And when I started playing FIFA, wanted to be good. Mm-hmm. I used Borussia Dortmund to improve myself, and then Dembele was the guy that actually got my attention. And when he signed for Barcelona, I did tell my friend that he's going to sign for them. I said, that's Ousmane type of player.
But like you said, injury,
that's the only thing that I can, yeah, but quality.
He's both footed, he's good on both feet.
And guess what? He's French. They're intelligent players. They got that charisma that makes football look easy. Mm-hmm. They make the hardest thing look easy. And that's one thing French and Dutch player and the Germans, of course. That's one thing they got. They all got it.
Cool.
Mm-hmm. What about Cavani and Mok?
I don't want Cavani. I definitely don't want Cavani.
I already knew the answer.
I don't want Cavani.
No? What about you, Alvaro Spice? Cavani in, 33 years old?
Free transfer? Backup striker.
But we already got Agallo though, no?
No, I don't know about Agallo. Backup striker.
You want to
know the backup striker? I'll keep Agallo than
have Cavani. Unless you can get someone else.
I'll keep Ngalo, because Ngalo showed me.
I know he's going. That's the reason why backup striker. We're going to have Ngalo and Cavani might get injured. He's injury prone as well.
He's still free agent.
Why are we going for injury prone players?
Because we don't want to spend money. We don't want to spend money.
Yeah.
This is what happens when you don't want to spend money. You go for not your second options. Mm-hmm. You're going for your fourth and fifth options. Because Dembele and Cavani, I didn't know nothing about them till today.
Mm-hmm.
I know they've been in the media, whatever, but I don't know. I don't want to see rumors like that.
You know what's so funny? All this time, we still haven't signed Tellers yet. We haven't signed this Tellers.
And I said it last video, right? Mm-hmm. Porto put down the money just for us to sign this player. And we still ain't done it.
Negotiating the add-ons, aren't we?
And it's scary though.
It is scary.
You watch your team play. We've watched your team play two Premier League games.
Mm-hmm.
We're scared already. We haven't got even half the quality. The Liverpool Man City, because this is the Liverpool Man City campaign for the title, right?
Yeah.
They take us to come underneath them two clubs, right? But we haven't got half of the quality. These two teams shown us already. Like for example, Liverpool, they're struggling. But he's still winning in style.
Damn.
Man City got trashed the other day, but when they're ready to come back the next game, they're gonna beat whatever team they catch, they're gonna beat them badly. I promise you like this, because we've seen that happen last season. But we're creeping, we're like toddlers, we're still creeping. I'm tired of it. I'm tired.
Alright, guys, as we are closer to the end of the show, we will just venture straight into that match preview against Spurs on Sunday at 4:30, guys, on Sky Sports, British Standard Time, you know what I mean? And we are playing at Old Trafford at home.
Yep.
Yeah. I don't know about you guys. Tottenham be looking decent at times. I'm hoping that Mourinho comes and plays his counter-attacking football against a team that costs that players to play counter-attacking football. My personal opinion of this match, I just don't know what will happen, but I hope we win.
Mm.
I hope we win. Because right now, I don't have that much confidence in terms of whenever we play a good team. I hope we win.
I think we will.
You think we will?
I think we will. I'm quietly confident. We're playing Tottenham on Tuesday. Home or away, I feel like in this COVID era with no fans, that really doesn't make too much of a difference. We will win. We'll get 3 points. I'm fairly confident. We've won the last three games now, albeit Brighton and Luton, but... let's get a 3 points.
How about you, Amok?
Fingers crossed.
Fingers crossed.
Yeah.
And
because the reason I say fingers crossed, I haven't seen anything convincing from Manchester United. Let me just see him beat Tottenham.
So like fingers crossed, you know. You're watching the match like this.
I'm not a negative person. Everyone knows me, I'm not a negative person. I'm one of the most strongest person. But Manchester have done number on me though. I'm being honest. They've actually touched me in a way that I've never been touched. I'm always that person that will lift everyone's spirit, but now they're trying to lift my spirit. So all I've got to say, maybe 50-50 because we're playing against Mourinho, his football is kind of trash. I don't care what player they got, as long as the manager of Mourinho, I think Manchester got a better option to win the match.
What do you think the scores will be?
It will be probably 1-0.
1-0 to Man United.
It'll be a tight game, 2-1 I reckon.
Because Mourinho know how to defend, set his defence.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what I'm saying. Mm-hmm. And our defence looking a bit shaky, but if you look, what we all conclude to you, if you got Bailey and Maguire,
yes,
I think we should be able to do
that. Mm-hmm. Absolutely, if he plays Bailey with Maguire, I'm not saying Bailey, bye. I'm Ivorian, I'm pronouncing it because of you.
Yeah, I'm saying how the white people, the English people saying it.
Yeah.
Like, bye.
Mm-hmm.
He's Ivorian, you can help me with it.
Uh-huh.
Bye.
Bye.
I've got my manager at work is called Bailey, so.
that's what you're trying to make. Guys, we have come towards the end of the show. You know what I mean, guys? It was wonderful. Remember to subscribe and smash that like button. Remember to share the video as always.
We need it. Share, subscribe, and trust me, this is just the beginning of a wonderful
thing. It's just the beginning. This is just the beginning, guys. And I'm more, where can the people find you?
As usual, you can find me on social media. My social medias are Amok Dinero, which that's my, what's it called? Snapchat, change my Snapchat. It used to be Amok, but now it's Amok Dinero. And my Instagram is prettyflaco_616, which is 16. The day of my daughter's birthday.
Yeah. So. TMI. Yeah. But still, Jax, what have you got in school for us this
week? Not in the library, though.
Not in the library. Yeah,
I quit the library. I'm watching United games through and through.
So where can the...
You can't find me. Find me next week on this channel.
As always. Mr. Anonymous, Mr. Discreet. Don't worry, if you really want to find him, go on the Reginald Instagram page.
No. That's the right thing he said. So which means, obviously, we know he is the calm and collected person among all of us. If you want to find this person, always keep tuning on to this show. Every week, tune up next week. Like, we love you guys though. I'm actually happy and I appreciate the feedbacks that we've been getting so far from you guys.
Positive.
And the views. Like, we just want to say thank you guys. We love you lot and we appreciate everything that you lot doing for us.
Yeah.
And this is just the beginning.
Just the beginning, guys.
Stay positive, United fans.
Yeah, me. And you can find me, of course, on my Snapchat as well. @Ivor_Spice. And the same thing for Instagram. And remember to follow the official Instagram page of Red United TV, which is Red United TV 1. Of course, subscribe, share. Remember to keep it united and keep it Red United, guys. Peace out.